Hi learners, in this video I'm going to talk about the duties and functions of a company secretary. The duties and functions of a company secretary can be bifurcated or divided into two types. One is statutory duties and functions, and the other one is non-statutory duties or functions, which are also called as general duties or functions. So let's now first look into the statutory duties or functions of a company secretary. Statutory duties or functions of a company secretary basically refers to those duties and functions of a company secretary that are prescribed or mentioned under the Companies Act of 1956 and also the Companies Act of 2013. Apart from that, there are various other duties which a company secretary is supposed to discharge, which are mentioned under other legislations or laws, such as Income Tax Act, Sales Tax Act, then under the Stamp Act, Industrial Disputes Act, under Contract Act. Then we have under the MRTP Act, like MRTP stands for Monopolies and Restrictive Trade Practices Act. So under various under all these legislations also, the secretary is supposed to discharge various duties. Now, some of the statutory duties which relates to the provisions of the Companies Act are the secretary is supposed to, it is the duty of the secretary to maintain the books and registers of the company. It is again the duty of the secretary to file the necessary returns and documents with the registrar of company. Again, the secretary has the duty to supervise the issue, allotment, transfer and forfeiture of shares. Now, there is a difference between transfer of shares and transmission of shares. Transfer of shares actually refers to when there is a transfer, or when supposing I'm transferring my shares to Mr. A and I'm receiving consideration or money for the shares which I'm transferring. Then it is called as transfer of shares. Whereas transmission of shares is supposing anything happens to me and or if I'm transferring the shares to my legal heir without taking money from them. If I'm transferring my shares to my spouse or my children without taking money from them, then it is called as transmission of shares. Forfeiture of shares refers to by taking back of shares in case the shareholder doesn't pay the share value. So in all supervising such issues, that is allotment, transfer and transmission of shares, is again the duty of company secretary. Further, the company secretary also has the duty to attend to various board meetings and general meetings and record the proceedings. And the secretary should also keep safe custody and proper use of the common seal of the company. The common seal of the company acts like a signature of the company. Then under the Income Tax Act also, the company secretary has certain duties, like making sure that, you know, it is a duty of the secretary to make sure that the necessary taxes are paid to the government on time. And also the secretary has to make sure that all the steps and have been taken to deduct the or compute the right amount of income tax and make the payment to the tax authorities. Now, under the Stamp Act, the secretary has to make sure that any documents which require stamp papers, the stamps of requisite amount are fixed on such documents. Again, under the Sales Tax, the secretary has to make sure that there is timely submission of returns and payments to the taxation authorities. And there are various other duties which a secretary has to comply with under various other acts, like the Factories Act, Industrial Disputes Act. So therefore, the secretary has to make sure that all the provisions of the various acts are complied with. Apart from the statutory duties, now let's move on to the general duties of a company secretary. Now, these are the general duties and functions of a company secretary. Now, the first is the functions of a secretary in relation to directors. Now, the secretary has to discharge various duties in relation to directors, like the secretary has to discharge the decisions discharge the orders which are given by the board of directors. Again, on the instructions of the chairman of the directors, the secretary has to convene board meetings, and the secretary also has to advise the directors during the meetings, board of directors meetings, and the secretary also has to act as a guide to the board of directors. Further, whatever clerical work has been assigned to the secretary on behalf of the board of directors, the secretary must execute it. Then while the directors lay down the broad policies of the company at the board meetings, it is the secretary who interprets and executes these policies. Therefore, the secretary also acts as a medium of communication or as a liaison between the board of directors and the outsiders or the shareholders. Further, the secretary acts as an agent of the board of directors. Therefore, the secretary must carry out all the instructions which is given to the secretary by the board of directors. And the secretary is also responsible for keeping the custody of the common seal of the company and using it on the directions of the board of directors. Further, on the instructions of the directors, the secretary also helps in convening of the meetings. And these are some of the duties and functions of the secretary in relation to the directors. Now, the next is functions and duties of a secretary in relation to shareholders. Now, shareholders are the actual owners of the company, and therefore, it is the duty of the secretary to safeguard the interest of the shareholders. Whenever there is any inquiry from the shareholders regarding the payment of dividend, issue of shares, the secretary has to provide the requisite information to the shareholders. Again, now when the secretary is dealing with the shareholders, the secretary must be very tactful and careful, and at the same time, the secretary needs to be very courteous and polite and helpful to the shareholders. Further, the secretary should make sure that no confidential information of the company is disclosed to a certain section of the members who may affect the interest of the company. Now, apart from that, it is the duty of the secretary to send letters of allotment to the shareholders, and even when the secretary, it is the duty of the secretary to make issue call notices to the shareholders. Like, the shareholders are supposed to pay the money on the shares. Now, the entire money on the shares is not collected at one go. It is collected in calls like the first call, second call, and final call. So, it is the duty of the secretary to issue these call notices to the shareholders. Again, whenever there is a transfer of shares, it is the duty of the secretary to certify the transfer. So these are some of the duties of the secretary in relation to the shareholders. Apart from that, the secretary should also maintain the minute book of the shareholders meeting and maintain the proceedings of all meetings and make sure that the share register and the share transfer registers are updated. So these are some of the functions and duties of a secretary in relation to the shareholders. Next is the functions and duties of a secretary in relation to office and staff. Now, it is the duty of the secretary to make sure that the various departments working in the organization are properly staffed and coordinated. Like, there are various departments in a company, like the finance department, HR department, marketing department. So, basically, it is the duty of the secretary to make sure that all these departments are functioning in coordination with each other. Again, it is the duty of the secretary to guide the staff in execution of the policies which is framed by the board of directors. And the secretary should make sure that at all levels, all the departments of the company try to safeguard the interests of the company. So apart from that, the secretary should also, is generally recognized as the head of the office of the company or as a principal office of the company. And therefore, he has to make sure that the office work is conducted or is carried out with maximum efficiency. And in order to get the best out of the staff or the employees of the company, the secretary should make sure that the overall duty of the secretary is basically to ensure that the right kind of candidates are selected and most competent workforce is recruited into the organization. Further, the secretary should also divert particular elections to the terms and conditions of the service of the employees and also maintain personal contact with the individual members of the staff. Functions and duties in relation to meetings. Here refers to the duties of a secretary in relation to both the board of directors meetings as well as the general meetings, like the annual general meeting and the extraordinary general meeting and the statutory meeting. Now, basically, the functions and duties of a secretary can be bifurcated into three stages. Duties of the secretary before the meeting. Then there are certain duties of a secretary before the meeting. Like in the case of general meetings, the secretary should first convene the meeting of the board of directors and with the board of directors, assist the board of directors in fixing the date and time for the annual general meetings or the extraordinary general meetings. Again, apart from that, it is the duty of the secretary to frame the notices and the agenda which has to be sent to the shareholders before the annual general meetings or the extraordinary general meetings. Further, it is the duty of the secretary to make sure to look after the seating arrangements, to collect the proxy forms before the meeting. And it is the duty of the secretary to make sure that the notice of the members is given, notice of the meeting is given to the members at least 21 days prior to the meeting. Apart from that, there are certain functions and duties of a secretary at the meeting. Like, the secretary should to collect the attendance slips from the members and make a record in the attendance register. Then based on the attendance, the secretary has to ascertain whether the quorum is present. Further, the secretary should assist the chairman in conducting the proceedings of the meeting, and at the same time, the secretary should also keep recording the minutes of the meeting. Finally, there are certain duties and functions of a secretary after the meeting. Like based from the minutes, the secretary should first prepare the minutes of the meetings and get it signed by the chairman. And the secretary should also make sure that the copy of the minutes is given to the registrar along with the necessary resolutions which are passed in the meeting. So, and further, after the meeting, the secretary should make sure that whatever decisions have been taken at the meetings is executed. Further, there are some certain duties and functions of a secretary in relation to the public. Like the secretary being in possession of all the important information and acts as a principal officer of the company. Therefore, the secretary also acts as a medium of communication between the directors and the general public, which consisting of debenture holders, bankers, solicitors, basically refers to the legal advisors, creditors, and also the prospective investors. Further, whenever information is solicited by the public, like any of the parties, like the debenture holders, bankers, solicitors, the secretary should provide the necessary information. And at the same time, the secretary should make sure that no confidential information is divulged to the public. Further, the secretary should function as a liaison officer between the shareholders and directors, the company and the outsiders, and should also discharge the duties in the best interests of the company. Now, there are certain duties and functions of a secretary before incorporation. Incorporation means registration of the company. Now, a secretary is appointed by the promoters of a company to assist the promoters to bring a company into existence. So, at the time before incorporation, the secretary has the duties and functions to prepare the various documents like the memorandum of association, the articles of association, and also assist the promoters in preparing these documents and also in completing the necessary incorporation formalities. Once the incorporation of the company is over, the secretary also has the duties and functions after incorporation. Like the secretary should supervise the work relation in connection with the allotment of chairs and also fix the board meetings and get the necessary resolutions passed so that the business of the company can be started with. Further, it is the duty of the secretary to make sure that the certificate of incorporation and also the certificate of commencement of business is obtained from the registrar of companies. And also the secretary should make sure that at all stages, the provisions of the Companies Act relating to incorporation of a company are strictly complied with. So these are some of the duties and functions of a company secretary.